गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू यूनिट दैट इज 2.3 हेट्रोसाइक्लिक केमिस्ट्री। वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द एग्रोकेमिकल्स। इन दैट टू सिंथेसिस पार्ट आर देयर। नाउ इन द 2.3 दैट इज हेट्रोसाइक्लिक केमिस्ट्री वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द अगेन टू और थ्री सिंथेसिस पार्ट्स ऑफ सिंथेसिस ऑफ पिरिडिन एंड ऑक्साइड्स, हैंड सिंथेसिस, स्ट्रिकर सिंथेसिस आर द डिफरेंट सिंथेसिस। सो स्टार्ट विद द हेट्रोसाइक्लिक केमिस्ट्री। द हेट्रोसाइक्लिक कंपाउंड्स आर दोज कंपाउंड्स विच आर present in the periodic tables and other than the carbons. So heterocyclic compounds are hetero atoms. That hetero atoms may be oxygens, it may be sulfur, it may be phosphorus, it may be nitrogens compounds along with the organic compounds, that is the carbon, hydrogens, hydrocarbons along with the hydrocarbons. So these are the heterocyclic compounds and the heterocyclic chemistry. First of all, we have write down the important structures of the heterocyclic chemistry chapters, chemistry units. That is, one is the pyridine and oxides having the six membered rings containing the nitrogen atoms. The ring is the aromatic rings. And nitrogen oxide and nitrogen atoms of the heterocyclic ring is attached with the oxygen atoms, hence it is called as pyridine N oxides. Another one is important structure of heterocyclic compounds is the quinolines. Quinoline is the benzene ring attached with the six membered nitrogen containing rings. It is also aromatic ring structures. And next one is the isoquinolines. Isoquinolines is also the heterocyclic chemistry compounds containing nitrogen atoms. The difference between the quinoline and isoquinoline is the only the position of nitrogen atoms only. Here the nitrogen atom present at the first, and the isoquinoline it is present at the iso, that is second positions of the ring. So these are the three most important ring structures. For your convenience and to understand and to write down practice, we have written it in the starting of the topics. So start with the first structures, first pyridine and oxides. So pyridine and oxide is the derivative of pyridine. It is the derivative of pyridine, means it is obtained from the pyridines by oxidations, which lone pair of electrons on the nitrogen is used to make the bond with the oxygens. By using the lone pair of electron on the nitrogens, how it is usable? We have the structures, that is the, this is the structures. In that, one carbon replaced by nitrogen atoms, all are the benzenes. Sorry, this is the become wrong structures. Nitrogen. This is the structures having the six atoms in the rings, and it is the aromatic ring structures. Here, nitrogen atoms. Here, the nitrogen atoms having the valency of the three. If nitrogen atoms is in the three valency, then it have the lone pair of electrons, that is unreacted lone pair of unreacted pair of electrons, that is lone pair of electrons. Here is the one with nitrogen atoms. So this nitrogen atoms with this unreacted lone pair of electron is free. It can be used for the reaction process, so it will be react with the oxygen atoms of any oxidizing agents, and this react and get that oxygen atom and form the oxygen minus means pyridine N oxides. This is the structure of pyridine N oxides. So N oxide can be function as the electron acceptor as well as electron donor depending on the reagents. Pyridine N oxide is more susceptible to electrophilic substitution than the pyridines. Positive charge ring nitrogen act as the electron, so increase the nucleophilic substitution reactions. Here is the nitrogen positive charge nitrogens acts as the electron sink to increase the nucleophilic substitution reactions. So you find that the nitrogen atoms having the four bonds, so the valency is changed, and this change valency is useful for the purpose of the substitution reaction, that is nucleophilic substitution reactions. So the friends, this is all about the nitrogen, pyridine and oxides. Wait 1 minute, disturbed. Continue. The positive charge rings is used as the increase the nucleophilic substitutions. Both the electrophilic and the nucleophilic substitution on the N oxide are easier than the for the pyridines. Both the electrophilic and nucleophilic substitution on the N oxides are easier than for the pyridines. So as the both the electrophilic and nucleophilic substitutions occurs at the 2, 4, 6 positions, the resonating structures of pyridine N oxides is as follow. If you look at the these structures, we find that these all are the having the positive charge at different positions, and these positions are useful for the electrophilic substitution reactions. So 2, 4, 6 positions are useful for the electrophilic substitution reactions. If you rotate in the negative charge on the overall ring structures, again we will get at the same position negative charge also. So 2, 4, 6 positions are useful for the nucleophilic substitution as well as electrophilic substitutions, means both the substitutions can be takes place at the position 2, 4, 6 position of the pyridine and oxides. So it is can be studied, and it can be studied by drawing the various resonating structures of the pyridine and oxides. And these resonating structures can be obtained by delocalizing the bonds present in the resonance. These bonds give the various structures of the positive and the negative charge. Positive charge is useful for the electrophilic substitution reactions, and the negative charge structures are useful for the nucleophilic substitution reactions. And the resonating structure of the pyridine and oxides you have to draw at homes by own, so that you can understand these structures. After practicing, it will be very useful, and you can draw the resonating structure of any compound. That is, you can be draw the for the benzene also. You can draw for the indole also. You can draw for the quinoline and isoquinoline also. So it is easy steps. So next point of this topic is the quinolines. You have studied the pyridine and oxide, the simple compounds. If you have some problems, so we can draw and study also, so you can understand the how can draw the resonating structures. So I have the one structures of the pyridine N oxides. This is the pyridine N oxides having the resonating structures. Here is the oxygen minus. The first structure you can draw, how you can draw, you can shift this bond has the nitrogen having the positive charge. If you shift this bond on the nitrogen, means the nitrogen loses plus charge. Nitrogen loses plus charge, and at the same time you shift this here, means this nitrogen atoms get converted into the non-chargeable nitrogen atoms. Here nitrogen atoms having no charge, bond shifted here, already bond is here. So these structures will be, so this compound will get here the positive charge. This is the first structure. Now we can delocalize this structure from here, you will get the positive charge here. If you delocalize the structures, here you get the positive charge here, means the three positive charge you will get. 1 2 3 2 4 6 numbers. 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 So you will get the at the center six different positions, six positive charge. This is all about the positive charge. If you draw this for the negative charge, though, so you will get the different structure for negative charge also. It is simple and easiest way to draw the negative charge also. Okay, if you shift here, means you get the negative charge here. Okay. Negative charge, nitrogen get having no positive charge and plus charge, plus charge. If you shift this bond here, okay, so you will get a negative charge here. If you shift bond this here, so you will get a negative charge here, means at the same time 2 3 4 5 and 6 2 4 6 having the negative charge also. Negative charge 2 4 6 having the negative charge also. That's why it is showing that at the 2 4 6 pyridine and oxide gives the nucleophilic substitution, and pyridine oxide gives the electrophilic substitution. Both substitutions occur at the same positions. So it is all about this pyridine and oxide. In the next lecture we will study the quinoline compounds. Okay, thank you friends, we will meet in the next lecture. Thank you very much.